that I could meet a bitch in a club and I can get something on my phone where I can test this whole, you know what I'm saying, you know, if this bitch real, real bad and I really don't want to put the rubber on, I can check this hole to see if she got stuff.
Pretty much.
Are you serious?
They have it in the UK. I think it's going to be coming here pretty soon.
Oh, it's going to be here.
They have it. It's not in the U.S. yet, but in the U.K. But, like, you can get the results before you even decide if you need to buy that drink or not.
Damn, but if you say the U.K.,
oh,
man.
You say the U.K.? Like, you've been a mob there right now.
Hey, maybe you can go over and get some.
So you would want that on your phone?
Heck yeah.
Hell yeah, nigga. Did I fail my Cadillac to get this?
All $35.
Can you imagine, like, now, because it says either urine sample or saliva.
So which means I can pretty offer you something to drink.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Swab that off the top of
it right
without
back.
You knowing it. Yeah, I'll be right back. And then
just take it right in the phone. Wow. Chlamydia.
Keep it moving.
Church.
I think that's brilliant and like, I don't know.
Is that invading your privacy though?
Heck well, yeah. I mean, I think if somebody is gonna use it on you, you should know.
Hey man, that's the future, son. That's what it's gonna be about.
But then if somebody asks you to use it and you say no, then that's like kind of an admission of guilt.
It's better if you can pee on the phone. I think that's better.
You know what? You can go. If you, R. Kelly, R. Speedy, want to go have people peeing on your phone, knock yourself out.
That's a disposable. That ain't the phone you keep. That's the one you go, just sprinkle something on there. 877-2-106-106 is the number to call into if you want to talk about one of our On the Burners.
Yes, sir.
That's right. Like Ricky's. That was
that was pretty cool.
Computer mouse.
Yeah. Well,
I'm just messing with you.
USB hanging from your skinny jeans.
No, you're talking about the pain ray. Yeah.
Well, actually, you know, for all you video gamers out there, and I know
I'm not one, but go ahead.
I am.
Actually, Microsoft recently announced that they're going to add this new thing to their Xbox video game system, which is going to replace the standard controllers.
Yeah.
It's called Project Natal, I guess is what they call it. And so you know how you use your Wii?
I looked at that word 20,000 times.
Well, I'm going to spell it N-A.
No, pronounce it.
I called it Natal. It could be Natal. I don't know.
better than me. I would have skipped right past it. This Project, thing called something.
Yeah, so basically what they're doing is they're going to have built-in motion sensors, that allow the users to act out their moves instead of having to press buttons. And so you know how
pretty
much
you could just walk in front of your video game,
start fighting,
act the damn fool.
You just start. You pick up your fake machine gun. You just start shooting. You know, like you if you're playing Street Fighter or whatever.
I don't know because you know one thing I know about gamers, they love having something in their hand, right, Rick? Y'all like to have the little thumbs and.
Right. Well, I just think gamers sit around on their buns all day long, so I can't see them wanting to get up and just start fighting.
They one hand is for getting high.
Gamers do not just sit on their buns all day.
Yes, they do.
What do you do, Rick?
Man, we play video games, son.
Gamers got really strong thumbs.
What are you talking about, man? We play,
Ricky, your thumbs look like... Ricky has very, like, Popeye thumbs.
Yep. So can you imagine if they take that away and now you got to get up and actually like throw the football now, Phil?
Son, yeah. I play football, son. That's nothing.
So how would you feel, since you're the gamer in the group, how would you feel? Because this isn't even like Wii.
They're not going to
Wii has the controller in your hand, but this one, they have.
Trust me. As well.
Trust me, it's still going to be dope. It's going to be dope. Yes, son. Come on, these video games now, are outrageous.
Do you do the Army ones too?
Of course,
Call
son.
Of Duty?
Right.
Son, so I got mine. At 12 o'clock when it drops, son.
Which one?
Right.
Call
Black Ops.
You know if you keep saying
Call of Duty, Black Ops.
Call of Duty, Warcraft. I'm all on there, son.
Right. And apparently
Madden,
what this thing is going to do.
NBA. I play all of them games, son.
Well, this thing is also going to have voice and face recognition software so you can distinguish between like the two players are fighting against each other.
I mean, you can already kind of sort of do that.
Yeah.
If you play with your headsets and you got your, you know, because it's a... It's online now. You can play online.
Because you play against other people.
Yeah, connect and you can talk, you know, crap, but you know.
877-2-106-106 is the number.
We have a caller on the line. We've got Al from New York. What's up, Al?
Al, what's up, though?
Al.
Yo, what's up? Hey, old boy that just couldn't find the weed. He needs to get with that old girl that y'all had on that Feezy they were advertising her shit on the
That's right. Yeah, the one who was giving out posters, giving out flyers.
Who was
giving? That was one of our old WTF stories where somebody got arrested because she was she just went out passing out flyers to where you could buy the weed from. You know.
And she went to jail.
Yeah, of course she went.
Who'd have thought that?
Stank week. Because there's something called stank week, right?
Yeah. Well,
Skunk.
You missed the joke, dog.
It's all right, Al. You know
but
what
thanks
I'm
for calling in, Al.
Yeah, we appreciate
it. Sorry, Al. You know, you can call
just
us
get your jokes in sooner. That's all. Don't wait that long to get that joke in.
That's hysterical.
Hey, remember when the thing about the weed in the mouth?
Oh, you stupid.
Tooth weed.
877-2-106-106. I know, Al. I can't read, so it's the same thing. Me and you in the same bunch, because I looked at the story and it said, pee on your phone.
No, Speedy. See right I'm going to need you to put your reading glasses on.
See? Oh.
Oh, wait a minute. Maybe. They're on.
Wow.
It says urine.
You might need a stronger prescription.
Guys, we're going to take a quick break here. And when we come back, we're going to go on to our iSex topic. We're going to talk about
sex. We didn't cover a whole lot of sex tonight.
Sexting. Yeah, we already
There's
did.
More?
But it's some more. We got more. Y'all know what it is,
man. We got more on iSex. Sexting coming up on the Foxhole Comedy
Corner. Serious 106 XM 149. Y'all know what it is. It's the Foxhole the Comedy Corner.
Yay.
I want to hear Black and Yellow.
Who's this? Gorgeous. Who's this? Oh, that's a. Yeah. The Lil Wayne?
All I want to do.
Oh, these not your song? Alert.
That's Waka. Ain't that Waka Blocka?
Oh, that's Waka Blocka.
Yeah, you know I'm on that right now. That's one of my songs, B. I'm sorry.
Did you see when South Park did a spoof on them?
Yeah, I'm a South Park dude.
Short but shorty.
Yeah,
it's hilarious, man. That's short but shorty.
While I do that, I won't.
We are back. It's the Fox Hill Comedy Corner. It's your boy Speedy.
It's Brandy McGee.
Ricky Harris.
And put the weed down, Ricky.
Hilarious. Well, guys, you know, it's time for our iSex segment where we talk about what's going on in the world of sex and sexuality today. Stop smoking.
Yes,
and this topic is actually very, very like on the forefront to me of technology and human behavior right now. We're talking about sexting.
Sexting.
No, do your spill again. Do that again.
I don't even know what I said. Spiel. I was just
you were
coming.
Like, this is on the burner of.
Speedy, I don't know what I was saying. I was just coming straight off the top of the dome.
Don't try to take our show to another level. We like being in the gut.
I was freestyling. That was totally freestyle, was Speedy. Like you know what I'm saying?
Nice. That was good, though, Brent. Go ahead.
Thanks a lot. Patting myself on the back.
iSex.
You have a cord hanging from your jeans.
Hilarious. I can't stand you, Speedy. Well, basically, in the news this week, a proposed Texas law would make sexting a misdemeanor for minors.
Okay, explain what sexting is.
First of all, sexting is the transmission of explicit messages or images.
Hey.
Basically, if you're sending sexy text messages,
I do it all day.
If you're taking camera phone pictures of your private parts,
I do that all day.
I know you do. And if you do it with someone who is under the age
No, I'm over the age.
But you know, some people are not. A lot of teenagers have phones, and so they are sexting each other, as teenagers will do.
Pornography.
So
isn't that the parents that need to?
Well, hold on a second. Actually, as it stands right now, Texas Attorney General Greg Abbott and State Senator Kirk Watson propose that they want to make the penalties for minors convicted of sexting less, because as it stands right now, if you transmit an image of a minor electronically
to a minor student,
to anybody,
right. Okay, cool.
If you transmit any image of a, say if you're a 15-year-old and you send a picture of 15-year-old genitalia, that is considered child pornography. So the problem that they're running into is that children are getting freaky with each other on their cell phones. So now all of a sudden you have a situation, if they're caught, you have a 15-year-old that was basically having innocent sexual play with their classmates.
Amen.
And now they're being convicted of a felony, child pornography. They're facing possible jail time, being registered as a sex offender.
You take the camera phone off the phone. How about that?
What happened to good old-fashioned grinding?
Well, they probably are grinding, but it's a new technological world. And actually, yeah, there also was a report going out this week that said that there's a higher risk of teen pregnancy linked to sexting.
How you going to get pregnant if I text you?
That's why you got to get back to grinding and finger banging. There you go. Eliminate all of that.
Here's what you know. My son, who's older now, I remember a young lady. What happened to writing notes? Remember?
Yeah, you can write somebody a note.
I went through my son's pocket.
Guys, it's 2010. I got you. Hold on. I go through my son's writing notes now.
I went through my son's pocket.
Okay.
Some girl had wrote him a note saying, I want to pull your little, which at that time, I'm pretty sure it was a little wickle. Pull your little wickle out, do this, that, and the other.
A wickle?
Yeah. So I called the mom. I knew the young lady. So I called the mom and said, you get over here and show me what your daughter was going to do.
Hilarious.
This dude is stupid, right?
So I mean, what do you guys think about the law, like, for them bringing it down? So
man,
basically,
you know what, Bran? It's out of control, and there is no pulling this back down. You know what I'm saying? We got to
no pun intended.
This wickle thing down.
We have to learn how to work with this, you know, this technology.
Parents need to step up. Parents need
no doubt about it. But step your game up, come on. Parents.
Teenagers are sexual beings. That's when you begin to explore your sexuality. Of course, every teenager except for Speedy's daughter.
Except for my daughter.
Except for Speedy's daughter. Teenagers are playing around. Like, that's when you start dry humping and finger banging and kissing and stuff like that. And if you want to make a comment about this, give us a call at 877-206-106. But do you think it's even right for the government to regulate our sexting and what we're doing?
It's out of control, Brian. They're not going to be able to control this. It's like, you know what I mean? It's too late. You know what I'm saying?
Rick, does your daughter text sexy?
Man, son.
Do you even look at her phone? Do you look at her phone?
I don't do none of that. She's a female. You know what I'm saying? I trust her to the point to where, you know, I actually see it. Okay. I let her do whatever she want to do, son.
It's the same thing.
Real spit.
I check my daughter's.
I get out.
I check everything.
I don't do that. I get out the way.
I check her.
I get out the way.
Email. I go on her account. She has a Facebook.
You gotta get out the way and let her be let her grow up.
I mean, he has every right as a parent to.
Yeah, he has a right to
monitor what his children are doing.
Yeah, I understand all of that.
I mean, that's his job.
If your daughter is wilding out like that, yeah, you're supposed to. You know what I'm saying?
Not Speedy's daughter.
You're supposed to get in. Get in them. But if they have no reason and they're not out there wilding out, they're not doing different things or whatever, you're supposed to let them grow up.
You're not supposed to know. On the phone. We've got black eyes. What's up, black eyes?
Oh, man, ain't nothing happening, man. I hear y'all talking about the PP phone and all that stuff.
You know? But, you know, pee on your phone.
Man, you know, that could be a useful tool, though, you know, because, man, you know, you can be up in the club with your gazelles and your Bluetooth, and you tell her, hey, you know, you go to the bathroom and pee on this, you know. And you come on back.
He
you know,
said gazelle.
Yes, sir. That's,
yeah, you know, you come on back. Everything cool. You clean, baby, but you pregnant. That's what my father
You 3 weeks pregnant. Did you know?
Hilarious. When was your last period?
Oh, that's funny.
Thanks a lot for the call, Black Eyes.
That's black funny, Black Eyes.
That was a good one, sir.
There you go. See how that works? See, Black Ice didn't call in on a joke he wrote down 2 weeks ago.
Black Ice, he's a seasoned caller. You know, he does this all the time. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Shout out to
now,
Black Ice.
Now, do I
sex?
Do you sex?
Sex?
No.
Do you have text you ever sexual
have you ever
things?
Have you ever taken a picture of yourself naked and
please say you did. Please.
Of course, I do not.
Every woman
I do not send pictures of myself
over. Get out of here.
Because here's the thing.
You've never done it.
So yes or no.
I've never
sent
don't breathe. It's a yes or no.
But I
yeah, she's done.
Can you answer the question?
What I was saying was,
Brandy, answer the question.
I've never sent a nude picture of myself over the phone.
Let's go to the phone.
Now, I have had somebody take a picture with their phone.
Of you.
Yeah, but we didn't send it. They just left it on their phone.
And you believe that?
Exactly.
I sent mine. I don't know why he didn't send it. Ricky, you send yours?
I sent mine. I've
heard it.
All the homies got it.
All the homies know what you look like.
No, they don't.
I got a camera in that bathroom. On the phone, I'd have said we got Bassman on the phone.
What's up, Bassman?
Bass.
How long did you go?
What's up with you?
What's good with it, Bassman?
Hey,
I wanted to weigh in on the subject when y'all was talking about the sexting or whatever you call that.
Yeah, go right ahead.
Go right ahead, man.
Okay, like, you know, like, as we as parents, you know what I'm saying, we need to monitor more things that our kids do, you know, like, even when you're on the computer with Facebook and things like that, you find all kind of perverted things